Hi everybody, welcome back. My name is Mr. Campbell from MrCampbellRocks.com. Today's video, I am going to show you how to use Google Forms to respond to passages of text. There's a couple different ways to do this. This is actually a specific question from a follower. Based on where we're at, my hope is that you have a basic understanding of Google Forms and how Google Forms works. How to create a Google form and choose what kind of questions you want, make those questions required or not. But we're gonna talk about how to get that text in there, both either as text or as an image, and we're gonna be using Fahrenheit 451, one of, if not my favorite novel of all time. So for those of you that are new to Google Forms, you can go to docs.google.forms, or you can go to forms.new, and it will create a new form for you. A form is a way basically to create a quiz or a test or gather information from a group of people that you share this with. My hope again is that you have that general understanding of that process. So we want to give our form a name and a title, a title and a name and a description below here. And I am actually in the edit stage of this. So I can choose what kind of question I want. I have all of these options here. Excuse me. And so what we're actually going to do is we're going to insert some text, both as an image and a regular text, to answer the following four questions. So you can see what I've done here is I've basically just typed out, read the following passage to answer questions 1 through 4. And when we're hovering here, we'll see this image right here, which means I can add an image. So the first way that we can do this is if I come over here and I take a screenshot. If you're on a PC, you can just use the screenshot tool. If you're on a Mac, it's Command-Shift-4. And we're just gonna grab this part right here. We would just wanna focus on this introductory paragraph when Montag is at his first burn. So this will automatically go to my desktop, or it should if I did it right, which maybe it didn't. So I'm gonna do another one. And so we want this here. This is the text. When we come back over to our Google form to insert this image, we can upload this. So we have a lot of options on where to grab this image. We can upload it from our computer. We can take something with our camera. We can do it by a URL if we have a URL of an image. We can grab stuff from our photos. We can grab a document from Google Drive. We can also search Google Image Search. Well, I just took this picture, so I want to upload it. And it's going to be right here on my desktop. So I grab that. It's going to pull that image in here. And you'll see now that I have an image of the text. So the kids can't highlight this or mark this up or anything like that. It's an image of the text. Then what I could go do after this is I could have my first four questions, right? I want to make this required. Maybe the first question is, I don't want to take time to think of the questions because I want to get through the process of this. So this is going to be a multiple choice question, right? When we copy this, it's going to come down here, and this is now question two. So this could be a short paragraph or a short answer. Maybe it's just we want to know what kids are thinking about this. So we do shorter answer, and we could ask them a question like, what do you think the author means by the number 451? Why is the number 451 significant? We obviously know it's in the title of the book and it's in our first paragraph. Why is 451 so important? Again, we're going to copy this. We're going to duplicate this. Now we can go down and do a paragraph question. And maybe what we want to have the kids focus on is the craft of writing. And so I love Ray Bradbury, but that's a whole nother video for another day. There's a lot of imagery here, right? We have the fireflies, which are basically comparing these burning embers of books and this house and this home that's on fire, comparing it to fireflies. We also have this imagery of a book looking like a flapping pigeon being burned, right? As the pages are turning brown into charcoal and the book looks like a pigeon. So we could ask the students how they feel about what's happening, right? The fourth question could have to do with a specific word. Maybe we wanted to highlight right here, stolid, right? That's a new word for most 8th or 9th or 10th graders. So we could have them, based on using textual evidence, what do they think stolid means? And we could either have that be a multiple choice, or a drop down, or a short answer, or a paragraph if they wanted to do that. So these are four generic questions, and you notice because I've actually copied the question, the text shows up in every question. So that's one way to get text into a Google form. The other way is to actually, so I'm gonna remove these now. The other way is to actually, I'll just do it below. We're gonna click on the plus side and add a new question. Use the following text to answer questions 5 through 7. And let's do checkboxes. It's fine. Here, what we can do is we can actually grab the text straight. Oh, here we go. We're going to delete all of this. And then we're just going to paste the text in here, right? And we would obviously, it's a PDF, so some of the spacing isn't great. There's a Google Docs online that have this text. But you can, anyway, you can see what I'm doing. You can pull the text in here. And when you have this text, you can put it in quotes like this. So that's the other way that you can put in text inside of a Google form. Then you would do very similar like what we did above. You could copy this question and all of that text copies right here so that the students don't have to go all the way up. And again, this is, I mean, if you have students that are the first time they're reading this or whatever, this is just a great thing to do for students. So they have the text on each question instead of scrolling up and down or going over to the text. There's a couple different options. You could have a PDF that they open in one window and answer the questions in another window. I don't love that because I feel like some students don't do well because of the process, not because of what they actually know. The best way to do this is to just grab a picture of the text and put it in. If you have an extremely long short story or you're reading like an entire short story, then you're going to have to do it another way where they're reading the PDF and then coming over to the form. But if you're just using a couple pages, you could set the images in here. Again, if you're here, it's most likely because you're an educator or somebody that works with kids. I love you, I appreciate you, and I am so glad that you're here.